Throughout his career, Elton has frequently collaborated with the hottest new artists. He shared the stage with Eminem at the 2001 Grammy Awards, and Eminem would go on to produce the posthumous Tupac Shakur track, Ghetto Gospel, which featured Elton John's vocals. Hit 'em with a little ghetto gospel. Those who wish to follow me, my ghetto gospel, I welcome with my hands.
He's quite up on new music. You know, there's the famous stories about how he goes into HMV and he buys 6-7 copies, one for each of his houses, and just walks around and buys everything. And whenever he's interviewed, he seems to be fairly knowledgeable and fairly up on what's happening. He did the thing with Eminem, which was really significant. Eminem was accused of homophobia a lot, and Elton John being openly gay. Man, was quite a thing for both of them to do.
People often forget what a great voice Elton John has. It's made for collaborating. They used Indian Sunset for Ghetto Gospel. Then you could see how Tupac's anger and Elton's almost spiritual way with words made for a brilliant song.
In 2010, Elton turned back the clock and teamed up with the artist that had inspired him, Leon Russell, to produce the album The Union. Leon and Elton met at the Troubadour when Elton first played in the US. This was a moment where Elton could now help his idol from being forgotten.
I'm standing outside.
That was a great moment when he went back with Leon Russell. Leon Russell was in his time, was a very influential person, and he fell out of view. His career really hadn't developed in the way that it should have done. And Elton John was being generous. He was paying homage. It was, this guy really helped me. I learned a lot, and I owe him a lot. So actually what he was doing was repaying a debt. And I think Leon Russell was very grateful for that. That's the best side of Elton John.
Another artist who had inspired Elton John was Freddie Mercury, whose tragic death was soon followed by the establishment of the Elton John AIDS Foundation.
If we raise $4 million like we did last year, I'll be ecstatic. So
I'm hoping
that. I'll put you in touch. OK.
Elton continues to produce new music and to collaborate with artists he has inspired, such as Lady Gaga, but also unexpected collaborators, such as Australian electronic act Panao, with whom he made the album Good Morning to the Night, which went to number one in the UK.
I actually think that Elton John's collaboration with Panao was a very savvy move. You know, Panao brought this kind of electronic disco influence, and Elton John brings the classic songwriting, and it was just a kind of match made in heaven, really.
I think that Elton John got a knack for picking the right artist to work with, and that Panao collaboration was really interesting. He always manages to look at what's going on and then pick out the right artist to work with, and it's, he doesn't kind of rubbish his for his own work by doing it. It's not like he cheapens himself by doing it.
He's one of these people, he kind of keeps going, he's very popular, people like him, and then every now and then he does something which connects with the zeitgeist on a big mainstream level, but at the same time then he'll go off and make an album with Leon Russell, and I really respect him for that.
He does an awful lot of good. He's a bit of a meddler as well. I get the impression he's a kind of rock and roll mother hen, calling people up when he thinks they have a problem, regardless of whether they actually do, and doing an awful lot of good at the same time.
It's hard to actually do that mainstream thing, and it's that, you know, it can't be faked, but it's even harder to do really interesting things when you are that mainstream, when you're that famous. It takes a certain level of bravery to know that you're going to make an album which probably won't sell much. That's not the point of it.